Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Ferris Sports Update. I'm your host, Rob Bentley, and thanks for tuning in. On today's show, we'll talk postseason as we talk Bulldog basketball and hockey here on today's show. And we'll start with Bulldog basketball and joined by head coach Andy Brockham. And coach, first of all, welcome back and congratulations on a great season for the Bulldogs.
Thanks, Robert.
Certainly since our last show, plenty of action going on here over the last 2 weeks. And we'll start with the GLIAC tournament. You win the GLIAC tournament. Just talk about that performance by your team to win the conference title.
Well, it doesn't happen very often, you know. I think the GLIAC tournament started, I want to say, in 1990, and this is our second title as a university. So it's very precious and hard to do. We got a home game, which was nice. We were able to defeat Ashland, and then matched up against Walsh. Very difficult matchup. It's a team that can really play offense, and they're real athletic. And then to meet the host team, Lake State, in the finals. And then that's the only team in the last 2 years that we haven't been able to knock off and to get a hot start there and hold on and cut down those nets. It was quite an experience.
You mentioned the win over Ashland. In that game, Josh Fleming, a junior for you with a big dunk that's had 45,000 some views on YouTube, really catapulted you into the semifinals against Walsh.
What an amazing play. You know, I coaching the game, and then for about 20 seconds there I was just a fan, you know, just overcome with emotion when you see a dunk like that. That's it's just a lot of fun. You jump up and down, pump your fist a couple of times, and then get back to coaching. But that dunk was something that we can hang on to, and everybody, you know, felt like they could get a little piece of. You know, eventually after talking about it and breaking it down so much, you almost feel like you dunked it in, because, you know, we just all stole a little piece of it, and we're glad Josh did that for us. So big game, beating Ashland. You know, they made a little run in the second half, and then closing that out was good to get to the Final Four of the tournament.
As we go to the highlights of that championship game against Lake Superior State, you got off to a great start, led 31-8, and really shooting the ball well here early in the contest.
Yeah, we came out executing our game plan, creating some open shots for each other and knocking them down. You know, just a reflection of how bad our guys wanted it. You know, our defensive game plan was okay. I didn't think we executed it as well, but offensively we were clicking, and we were pretty gritty down the stretch, held our composure, and you know, made some big free throws down the stretch, and you know, some strategy to foul, which always makes you a little nervous, but we executed it, and we had been practicing in practice, and it worked out for us.
Great crowd on hand here at Buck Cooper Gymnasium. Got off to that great start. Drew Lehman, a big game for you with 38 points.
That game's one of the best, you know, single game performances in the history of Ferris State. And I mean, this time we came out on top. He had 37 against Hillsdale earlier this year, and to have 38 in the championship game on the biggest stage is an incredible performance.
We've got some great contributions from other players as well. We saw Dietrich Lever, another senior for you, with a big game. Here's Lehman down the stretch with a big three and hit some big free throws down the stretch to really ice the win.
Well, yeah, and Drew Cushenberry, freshman, stepped up, made some big free throws, and you know, you saw some of the earlier shots in those highlights of Dietrich Lever catching and shooting, hitting that one from NBA range. That's just a senior stepping up. He's been there in those big moments for us in his career, and you know, they got it done.
How exciting was it for your team to be able to cut down those nets to secure that automatic bid into the NCAA tournament?
It's just something you're going to remember forever. You know, the best part of it is sharing it with everybody else that cares and that supported you throughout the year. So just cutting that net apart and handing it to different people and just the hugs and the embraces, it was a lot of fun. It was a great experience.
That was a Sunday afternoon. You come back home, and as soon as you get back to town, the selection show was on a Sunday night, and you had some great supporters out of Buffalo Wild Wings in Big Rapids as you found out who you play in the NCAA tournament. Unfortunately, it was Lake Superior State again.
You know, you could twist it either way. I mean, it is a little awkward to play a team four times. It's like you feel like you're in the national tournament. You should be playing in a national tournament. But it's a regional format, so there was pretty much little doubt we were going to match up with them again the way we saw the seeds working out. So, you know, we twisted it into a positive, and it was a team we knew we could beat. We just got done beating them. So when you're playing a team in the first round of the tournament that you know you can beat, that's a real good thing. So. It also allowed us to prepare a little bit, you know, for the next teams with advanced scout, just because we were so prepared for Lake State, you know, already playing them three times this year.
You met Lake State for the fourth time here in the NCAA tournament, fourth time this season, playing them in the first round of the Midwest Regional down in Louisville, Kentucky on Saturday night. And talk about that performance. But your team had an opportunity to win the game.
You know what? We didn't play our best. You know, our defense was a more sound team approach, how we wanted to play in the championship game. But some of their veteran players, Alex Williams, you know, he just made some great plays. And that gave them, you know, a 6-point lead-ish for the majority of the game. We made a run and, you know, took the lead 5 points with under a minute to go. And then, you know, March Madness happened. You know, they had a non-shooter make a 3-pointer. And we had an unfortunate turnover in a situation where we've been in multiple times this year. And they made another big play, the layup, to tie it up. And then they just beat us in overtime. They kind of took the momentum and ran with it. So, classic game. And our guys fought hard to the very end, real proud of them.
You mentioned that fight led by three seniors playing their final games on the floor. Drew Lehman, Dietrich Lever, Matt Stuhl. What have those guys meant for you?
They're incredible players, you know. Dietrich and Drew, two-year captains, champions as freshmen, champions as seniors. Played logged a lot of minutes for the Bulldogs and played a lot of big games. And, you know, kind of been through an up and down, you know. It wasn't really a rebuild, but, you know, a retool, you know, with the coaching change and some players leaving, some recruits, you know, going elsewhere. And then just to come back and win the GLIAC tournament, testament to their character. And then Matt Stuhl, you know, coming in after community college. Definitely three Bulldogs for life. Couldn't be prouder of those guys.
Final score 78-69. Doesn't diminish what Bulldogs were able to accomplish this season. 23-9 as you look back on this year here after a few days. What will be some of the big accomplishments for your team?
Oh, there's just a long list of them. And I mean, obviously cutting down the nets was the biggest one, but the win streaks and the tying the most wins ever for the you know, in a conference season was 16, and, you know, beating some teams that we haven't beaten in their gym, and, you know, a Division I victory, and right on down the line, you know, Drew becoming a 1,000-point scorer, and there's just so many things, and we get to talk about them here when we have the end-of-the-year banquet, but what a special year, and it just makes me hungrier for next year and setting it up for next year and a return to the tournament, and I hope our guys are hungry too.
I know over the past couple weeks, all season long really, but especially the last couple weeks, some great fan support with the band traveling to games, fan bus. Talk about that support leading the GLIAC in attendance this year.
You know, it's something I don't think you can, I mean, you try to create it, but it's just got to kind of happen spontaneous. And the response we've had from the community and the school has been outstanding this year. We led the league in attendance. We set record attendance for New Wink Arena. The band, the parents, the supporters, the Rebounders Booster Club members, it's just been great. So we're looking at the other places that have home courts that are maybe a little bit better than ours right now. We're just going to try to get to that point, and I know we're well on our way.
Well, Coach, congratulations again on a great season for the Bulldogs.
Thank you.
We'll be back with more Ferris Sports Update right after this.